I'm one of those people that loves discovering new things and learning about the world. I like meeting new people. I like reading. I like traveling. And I think this comes from a deep-seated desire to know why. Why are things the way they are today? How did they come to be? How are they made? And so I can't think of a more perfect job than to be a historian, and a special type of historian called a curator. That means that I take incredible interest in material culture as a source of information. I'm Debbie Douglas. I'm the Senior Director of Collections and Curator of Science and Technology at the MIT Museum. I've been here since August 1, 1999, so just over 26 years. The MIT Museum got its start in 1971 when Warren Siemens, who was the chief administrator in the humanities division, was asked if he might put together a small exhibit about the history of MIT. And Warren, who was a MIT history buff, rummaged through closets. He hunted down photographs and paintings. He made this great discovery one day of a portrait of William Barton Rogers that everyone had thought had been lost. And when this exhibit was done, people thought it'd be a shame to kind of put this away. It's pretty interesting. And so a little committee was formed, the Committee on Institute Memorabilia. That turned into the Committee on Historical Collections that officially became the MIT Historical Collections. And in 1981, that became the MIT Museum and Historical Collections. So MIT had great ambitions, but its collections were in such primitive state. And I'll be honest, when I first walked in and took a look around, my sense was, what a diamond in the rough. Anyone in the history of technology knows about MIT and is interested in it. In fact, that was William Barton Rogers' founding vision for MIT, which encompassed the idea of a museum. He felt that there needed to be a place at the Institute where students could learn from objects, learning how to experiment with instruments, to re-examine the world. And our museum, I think, most wholly embraces that vision. So here we are, 160 some odd years later. 1.5 million objects is our current guess, and with those objects, we can tell an unbelievable story about the history of science, technology, engineering, education in the 19th, 20th, and 21st century. These are things that people made, the things that people used. These are things that changed people's lives. And so for us, it's just a privilege to be able to steward these materials. We work collaboratively with partners across the Institute, Distinctive Collections, MIT Video Productions, with the News Office, with the Facilities Archives. We work together in the labor of preserving MIT's history. We do it because we think the past has insight for us in the present, and more importantly, is a resource for us to help make a better future. I think the new museum ought to be a place where people come in and discover new things, learn new things, experiment, have conversations, engage with each other. And our collections are something that I want people to feel exactly the same way about, that they're for everyone. It doesn't matter your education. You don't have to be a member of the MIT community. You just have to be insanely curious about our world and want to know the answer to the most basic question, why?